not.
That might be just for recording, so if it's okay, leave it. Otherwise, you can hold the mic.
SCADA stands for supervisory controls and data acquisition. Right? This SCADA is also known as HMI. It's widely used in industry to monitor real-time status of a factory or a plant. The main function of HMI is self-explanatory. It's to translate machine signals into human-friendly signals, such as by sound or visual, specifically animation. And the question is, why SVG is SCADA? The demand of SCADA over web has been increasing. Many SCADA companies try to port their system to work over the internet. However, they require specific software to be installed. So, when SVG is introduced, it immediately drew our attention because the client does not need to install anything except SVG for the browser. So this is a basic SCADA screenshot. It consists of the details of every connected equipment. For example, this is a pump. Red color stands for stop, and green stands for running, and yellow for problem trips. This is color animation in SCADA. The water tank beside is a level animation, while the tanks above showing temperature here is a text animation. In this presentation, I'll focus mainly on five major animation in SCADA. They are color level, move, opacity, and rotate. To perform the animation, we use JavaScript to access into the SVG DOM and change their property or attributes periodically. For example, to achieve this, we have modified Inkscape with object properties to create an interface for user to configure the animations of the object. These animations, these configurations will then be converted into JSON-based syntax called exec, which is regressive SCADA animation code. And this exec code will be stored into the SVG file as an attribute. When this SVG file is being opened at client side, a JavaScript engine will start gathering data from the server and perform the animation according to the configuration set. However, this implementation we are doing has a small little drawback, that is, we cannot achieve a smart animation which is smooth. All the five major animations I mentioned can be applied by using Animate, the current SVG animations. They are Animate, Animate, Constrain, and Animation. However, all these animations are time-oriented. We must specify when the animation to begin, to end, and also the duration of the animations. So, we cannot specifically tell what animation to be carried out when something has happened. This is very critical in a manufacturing plant. So to work around this, we can use a JavaScript to append new animate tag into an SVG object every time the object has a state. But this is not practical in SCADA software because some object has a very short duration between state change. So below is this is a comparison between the implementation we are doing and the smart animation. From the limitations, we introduced the concept of state-oriented animation. this state-oriented animation has a is generally similar to the current SVG animation, but has a state attribute here. The begin and end attributes is removed because it's not time-oriented. The duration is kept to determine the transition time between states. To change the state, we will use JavaScript to set attribute state. This slide will show you how I'm going to propose to SVG open the state-oriented animation can be applied. For color animation, in this, the states of this color is defined in color attribute. In this example, there are two states. There are two states which are separated by a semicolon. So default color of this example is 0, which will take the first color. When this object, the example is here, when the state is changed to 1, it will take 2 seconds for this object to change color from blue to red, which is the second state here. Level animation is usually used in indicating a depth of a water tank. The attribute, the from and to attributes indicates the maximum, the range of minimum and maximum of this object can reach. State attribute of this animation takes a number between from and to indicate the current level of this water. Duration works same as the above, which it will take 9 seconds for every state change. But this is actually a GIF file, so it's not following this. Move animations, the state of this animation is using the percentage to indicate the current position of this of the object. So duration is also the same as the above. It will take 6 seconds to reach from one state to another state. But this is a GIF file. I cannot do it in because it's not implemented. Opacity here is generally similar to the current SVG animation. From and to means the minimum and maximum opacity. And the state will take the number between from and to. Duration works same as the above. So in this example, when it's 1, it will take 2 seconds to change from 0.5 to 1. Rotate animation, the state attribute of this animation is a degree of the position or the direction. It's generally same as the above examples, except the duration and state I have mentioned. Time-oriented animation are not meant to indicate the life status of an object. For example, this aircraft flying force is usually accompanied by a number of loops. It looks like a general idea of a situation where accuracy is not the question. While state-oriented animation gives a more specific location of the aircraft. So this will definitely benefit all the real-time application. Besides SCADA, other applications such as game or simulations might also benefit from this state-oriented animation. However, this concept is basically developed from our experience in developing SCADA. So it might not be fully right away useful to other applications. So I hope the SVG community can look into the possibility to make this happen. So to make SVG more competitive among these competitions. Thank you.
So it seems like you might be able to get a lot of this just using the begin and end method calls on animation elements, because you can actually, if you're already using scripting to presumably to set the state attribute that you're proposing, you could just as easily get the animation element and call begin on it at the time that you want to set the state, I think.
Yeah, we actually tried to use the function begin element add, right?
Uh-huh.
That's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
It is actually still using time to stop the forcefully stop the animation, right? So what I'm talking is we this animation is made of control by state, something controlled by state, not by time. So if we have to use begin element add, end element add, we will have to scale the state into time. Forcefully stop it, right? So there's the limitation here.
So I guess it's more or less the follow-up of that suggested, which is being done, because actually you can specify when to start and stop. If you use the begin element and end element that was already stated, but instead of specifying a from and to intervals, you simply say begin indefinite, and it will only trigger when you go to the DOM element and trigger it with a scripting or with a mouse event. So that part, I guess, can be done. Just a suggestion.
Do you mean that this object can only change once?
No, you can change many times as you want. You can start the animation frozen initially and only trigger it when desired. I guess we are already doing that in our latest improvements or things like that, to trigger animations only when state changes. So. Actually, we do something like this, and use smile for that, and trigger animations when state changes, and we use begin and end element, as was already proposed. Actually, I'm not sure if I can do a couple more. You could probably also use. The thing is, I didn't quite understand the state attribute. Was it something which was live in the DOM, which you could change the state? What was the state? I couldn't actually understand the attribute. How would it be used? Was it to specify a default value for the animation?
The state
couldn't quite follow.
I think Carlos has some follow. This state is related to this color, which is the configuration of the state. So when the state is zero, it will take the first state.
So if you manipulate the state attribute with JavaScript, you'd expect the color to change to the second one?
Yeah.
Would it be it?
Alright, are there other questions? No?
Alright. Okay, maybe just one more.
One more?
This is another suggestion, I guess. You can actually do as you said, you have to map state with time, and you can position an animation in a given moment of time using any file. So you have the base value, which is the DOM, which is in the original XML declaration. But you can change the animated value of it using the DOM. Fortunately, this is a suggestion, and you'll probably and see that it's not still widely implemented, I guess. It's in Opera and WebKit, I guess. So.
That doesn't get the interpolation that I think. Like, it would get smooth interpolation, like an animation would.
Yeah, it's just to put it in there and then begin it or stop it. Just something like that. That's all I
Alright, one question here.
Were you able to work around these problems you experienced to get to a solution that worked as you expected it to work, in a way?
Okay.
You explained the problems you experienced when you were trying to do what you wanted to, and were you able to work around these problems in some way, find a solution for the problems? Using JavaScript, using tricks.
Yes, we can actually use the current SVG animation, but it will, as I mentioned here, this workaround is to, it looks like append a new animate tag into the object, and when it has another state change, we remove and append a new one. So, but this workaround is not practical because sometimes the object, a single object, has a lot of state change within 1 second. So, if it has 1,000 of objects same as this, it will crash.
Do you have an example in SVG here to show us?
So you said your editing environment was based in Inkscape using a plugin. Is that available? Is the project available?
Yeah.
I can show you the Inkscape we have modified.
I'm curious.
This is the state of configured in the bar animation in the object. So it will follow the data which is simulating every second 0 to 59. So it will keep on moving to 59 and become 0 again. So this is what we are doing.
Any more questions? Thank you very much.